everyone, it's Farkad here. And in this video of the forest, I'm going to show you how to craft every item in the game. Now, I doubt that anything's changed on PlayStation 4, as it's just released. It should be the same on PC and on PlayStation 4. I'll put timestamps for every item in the description. Now, if you haven't played the game in some time, some items have been removed or changed. So I recommend that you do watch this video. And without further ado, let's get into it. Now, if you're on PC, you can put the mouse cursor over the cogwheel and it will show you what you can make with the resources you have on the crafting mat. I'm pretty sure this should be the same for PlayStation. So if I put a stick and a rock on the crafting mat, it'll show that I can make a crafted axe and a repair tool, and it shows the little icons of the things needed next to it. If you place a rope on it, you can see all the items you can make. There's quite a lot. This is a rather new feature to the game. I'm going to start with weapons first. To make a crafted axe, you need a stick, a rock, and a rope. You can only carry one. This is a pretty bad weapon. You also don't need to craft it. Some cannibals do carry it, and they'll drop it upon dying. To make a slingshot, it's one cloth, one stick, and one duct tape. This is an excellent weapon for hunting. I highly recommend you get it very early on. It uses small rocks as ammo. It's got an area of effect. It's great against lizards, rabbits, and other small animals. You can only carry one. To make a crafted bow, it's one stick, one rope, and one cloth. This is a very basic bow. There's a more advanced modern bow in the game, but you gotta find it, and it's deep within caves and it's very difficult to get to, though this can do the job. To make a crafted club, it's one stick and one skull. This is a relatively good weapon. It's slow, but it's hard hitting. To make an upgraded stick, it's one stick and one cloth. This is a pretty good weapon. The fire upgrade on it is probably the best in the game. It burns the longest and it swings relatively fast. Once the cloth is burnt off the upgraded stick, you just apply another one and then you can light it on fire again. You can only carry one upgraded stick. To make an upgraded rock, it's one rock and one cloth. This is an okay weapon. You can't block with it. It does a lot of damage, but it swings very slow. You can light it on fire, but it will light you on fire. So not recommended. You can only carry one upgraded rock. To make a weak spear, it's just two sticks. Weak spears are excellent for throwing at deer. You can only carry one, though you can make a spear bag to carry five at a time. Use this as your throwing spear. The upgraded spear and weak spear when thrown do the same amount of damage. They're also good for killing tortoises when you throw them at them. To make an upgraded spear, it's one weak spear, two cloth, and three bones. You can only carry one of these. It doesn't fit in the spear bag. This is actually a rather good weapon for melee combat. Don't throw it because you could lose it. As mentioned, the weak spear does the exact same damage when thrown. As it does use up your weak spear, you can just make another one. To make an incendiary spear, if I pronounce that right, it's one upgraded spear, one booze, and one cloth. You can still only carry one upgraded spear. When you stab something with this, it doesn't explode. It only explodes when it's thrown. It doesn't destroy the spear, so you can still collect it. You'll have to add booze and cloth again if you want to make it the same. This is a minor spoiler, but there is a gun in the game. It's called the flintlock pistol. And you've got to collect all 8 parts for it, which are found in 8 spots hidden across the map. You'll need explosives to open them. Little rock mounds. Once you've got all 8 pieces, you can craft the flintlock pistol. It is not a very good weapon, though if you're good at headshots, you'll do pretty well with it. It uses old gun ammo, which is quite rare. To make normal arrows, it's one stick and 5 feathers. Now at this stage of the game, it's probably best to just use modern arrows as they're so easy to find and they respawn. Though if that ever gets removed, this is how you do it. You can carry 30 arrows at a time until you make a quiver. To make bone arrows, it's one stick, 5 bones, and 5 feathers. These do about 40% more damage than the normal arrows. Though modern arrows do more damage and they're much easier to get. I would recommend saving your bones for bone armor at this stage, unless things change. To make poison arrows, there's 4 possible recipes. You add the arrows, any arrows. Just keep in mind that whatever arrows you use will turn into normal arrows after being fired. So if you use modern arrows, they'll turn into normal arrows. So best to use normal arrows or whatever you got spare. You can add 1 Amanita mushroom and that will make a batch of 5 poison arrows. Poison arrows slow the movement speed and attack speed of enemies, and it adds a dot of poison damage, like damage over time. The damage is rather low, though slowing them down can be very useful, especially against bigger mutants. The next recipe is jack mushrooms and 5 arrows. The next one is 4 snowberries and 5 arrows. And the next one is 4 twin berries and 5 arrows. They all do the same thing. If you eat any of these mushrooms or berries that I've just mentioned, you can get sick and it will damage you. And they are extremely poisonous on hard survival. Keep in mind you need a pouch to collect mushrooms and berries. Once the poison arrow is fired, it will lose its poison effect, even if it misses. A good trick is to hit him with a poison arrow and then switch to normal arrows. To make fire arrows or incendiary arrows, it's 5 arrows, 1 booze, and 1 cloth. If you use poison arrows to make these, it will override the poison effect. You can't stack them. You can also add poison multiple times. Same with the fire upgrade. It doesn't do anything. So just add it once. To make a Molotov, it's one booze and one cloth. I believe you can hold 10 of these. I can't quite remember. To make a bomb, it's one circuit board, one booze, one electrical tape, one wristwatch, and one coin. You can hold 5 of these. You can turn it into a sticky bomb by adding a piece of sap to it. Sticky bombs share the same space with normal bombs, so you can only carry 5 in total. Sticky bombs will stick to the target when thrown, can be much better for killing cannibals, as cannibals will run away from bombs. To make a head bomb, it's one head and one bomb. It doesn't matter if it's a sticky bomb, it will still work, though it won't stick. Head bombs do a lot of damage, though they take forever to blow up, and they keep rolling when thrown, so it's very hard to hit your target. Though you can carry one of these and 5 bombs as well, so it can be good to use up the materials if you're ever going to waste them. To make lizard armor, you just click on it and it adds to your armor bar. It has the same amount of armor as stealth armor, though you don't get the stealth effect. It's best to add leaves, as leaves are very easy to get. You can hold 10 lizard skins. Speaking of which, to make stealth armor, it's 1 lizard skin and 15 leaves. You can carry unlimited leaves, so it's quite good to know. When you wear it, it will show up as green. You can carry 10 stealth armor. To make bone armor, it's 6 bones and 3 cloth. This gives 40 armor, whereas lizard and stealth armor only give 20. And it will show up as white in the armor bar. You can carry 10 bone armor. To make snowshoes, it's 5 sticks and 2 rope. These increase the speed you can move in snow by 15%, I believe. Sand actually slows you down as well, though the snowshoes don't work on sand. You can only carry 1 pair of snowshoes. To make rabbit fur boots, it's 3 rabbit skin and 2 rope. These increase your stealth, and I think they still add armor, though they're not supposed to. You can only wear 1 pair of shoes at a time, and when you click on them, it doesn't remove them from your inventory. The best way to tell which one you're wearing is to just look at your feet. These are permanent items, as in they cannot be destroyed by the enemy. You can only carry 1 pair of rabbit fur boots. To make a warm suit, which is the hardest to make item in the game, it's 1 raccoon skin, 1 rabbit fur, 4 boar skin, 6 deer skin, 2 cloth, and 2 rope. This acts like a full suit of armor, so once you equipped it, it removes all your other armor. You don't want to lose this. If you're going to be engaging in battle, use proper armor. A good trick I learned while making this video is that you can remove all your armor by putting on the warm suit, because you can't remove armor once you place it usually. You can only replace it with other armor. You can only carry 1 warm suit. To make a water skin, it's 2 deer skin and 1 rope. This is a very important item. You should try and get it early on. You can only carry 1 water skin. To make a pouch, it's just 2 rabbit furs. This allows you to collect berries and mushrooms. You can carry 10 of each mushroom and 30 of each berry. If you're in multiplayer, you don't need the pouch to share berries. You can still carry berries, you just need the pouch to collect them from the bushes. This is what you should be using your first rabbit furs on, a pouch. You also collect seeds as well. You can only carry 1 pouch. To make a stick bag, it's 1 rabbit fur, 3 cloth, and 2 rope. This increases the amount of sticks you can hold by 10 to a maximum of 20. This is a very helpful item. As you can carry more sticks, you can build a temporary shelter in caves if you need to save, as they require 14 sticks. So I'd recommend you get a stick bag early on. You can only carry 1 stick bag. To make a rock bag, it's 1 boar skin, 1 cloth, and 3 rope. This increases the amount of rocks you can carry by 5, up to a maximum of 10. You can only carry 1 rock bag. It's a very useful item. To make a throwable rock bag, it's 1 rabbit skin and 1 rope. This increases the amount of small rocks you can carry from 10 to 25. They're also known as throwable rocks. To make a quiver, it's 3 rabbit fur and 1 rope. It increases the amount of arrows you can carry by 20, so from 30 to 50. To make a spear bag, it's 2 deer skin, 2 boar skin, 2 cloth, and 3 rope. This increases the amount of weak spears you can carry, from 1 to 5. It doesn't store other spears. To make a repair tool, or a repair hammer, it's 10 sap, 2 cloth, 2 sticks, and 1 rock. This is excellent for taking out stick trees, as it doesn't use any stamina. To make rope, it's 7 cloth. I recommend you only use this in emergencies, or if you're desperate, or if you're just lazy. Reason being is cloth is actually quite hard to find, and you need it for bone armor and other things. You can carry unlimited cloth, but you can only carry 4 ropes. I recommend you learn how to store rope. I'll put a link to a video on showing you how to do it. It's really easy. To make health mix or herbal medicine, it's 1 aloe vera and 1 marigold. Gives you 50 health points. Though there are so many meds in the game, sometimes I don't think it's worth it. Though it can come in handy, and it does use up the herbs if you've got spares. You can carry 5 of each mix and 10 of each herb. To make a health mix plus, it's 1 coneflower, 1 aloe, and 1 marigold. I believe this heals you completely, 100 hit points. To make an energy mix, it's one cone flower and one chicory. This restores energy, but it also restores stamina, which can be good mid-fight. To make an energy mix plus, it's one aloe vera, one chicory, and one cone flower. This, I'm pretty sure, restores almost all of your stamina. I've got a consumables page that I wrote up on the wiki. I'll put a link to that as well. Show you what these actually do. To upgrade your weapon, you place the relevant weapon on the crafting mat with tree sap, and you can choose from feathers, teeth, or glass. Feathers increase the speed of a weapon, though reduce its damage. Teeth increase the damage of a weapon, but reduce its speed. Glass increases the damage of a weapon quite a lot, but it reduces the speed even more so. It's automatic placement. It used to be custom placement, but then they removed it. Which upgrade you use depends on the type of playstyle you've got. Though certain weapons I do not recommend upgrading with speed, such as the weak spear or the upgraded stick. It just reduces the damage too much to a point that it doesn't really do any damage. Enemies will regenerate faster than you can kill them. Though my personal favorite is glass. Try using a mix also. If you only use one upgrade type, the benefits start wearing off the more you apply. It's really complicated. I've got an upgrade video. Some of the things have changed in it. Blah, blah, blah. I'll put a link to it anyway. To make a poison weapon, you need to add bladed or sharp or pointed weapons. So like axes and spears and stuff. And it's the exact same recipes as the poison arrows. So 4 snowberries or 4 twin berries or 1 jack mushroom or 1 amanita mushroom. I believe it's only got one hit until it wears off. So if you hit a tree, it wears it off. It's really tedious to use these. To make a fire upgrade, select a relevant weapon, add cloth, and it's done. There used to be a fire plus upgrade, but it was removed from the game. For reasons unknown. To make a flashlight upgrade, it's 1 flashlight, 1 duct tape, and either the chainsaw, modern bow, crafted bow, or flintlock pistol. It does use up your flashlight, though you can find more. If you want to take it off, you just disassemble it on the crafting mat. You do lose your electrical tape though. Though as you find these flashlights, you can attach them to all the relevant weapons. All these weapons are intended to be two-handed, so you can't use a flashlight while you're holding them. They're very good in caves or at nighttime. I'm not sure if you can turn the flashlight off while you're holding the weapon. It's automatic. They might fix this eventually. Though all the torches share the same battery life, so to recharge it, put a flashlight on the crafting mat and recharge it. If you've only got one flashlight and it's attached to the weapon, I think you have to remove it to recharge it. I'm not sure. The mechanics for this are rather new and it's kind of weird. And finally, the flare gun. To create ammo for the flare gun, you need to just add the flare gun and add flares to the crafting mat. The flare gun can carry unlimited ammo. It's good to use up spare flares to save wasting, as you can only carry 10. To see how much ammo you've got, just place your cursor over the flare gun in the inventory. There's also a trick on PC where you can right click and hold it down or hold down control when adding items to the crafting mat and it will batch add them. Meaning it will add a lot. Can be quite useful, though it's quite chaotic. It adds a lot. I don't know if this feature's on PlayStation or what controls it is. It should be on there though. Though those are all the items in the game that you can craft. On the Forest Wiki, I've actually made up a full crafting list with pictures and everything. That's all up to date. And it's got more information on there as well. Too much to cover in one video. Anyway, I plan to make more videos like this, more beginner guides for the PlayStation players. So if you're wanting to know any information, let me know in the comments. The game is quite hard to start off with, though it does get easier. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.